Hello everyone, Kyle Bascombe here, our Mercedes Catalog Manager, and today we'll be discussing Mercedes W211 transmissions. We're gonna go over the basics of the transmissions offered, then we'll take a deeper dive into some of the common issues across the platform, how to service, troubleshoot, and diagnose those transmissions as well. Let's get right into it. We're going to start by talking transmissions. I want to begin by showing you one of the most common problems that I observe with transmission service on these vehicles. So when they were first introduced, they were introduced with the 5-speed Mercedes 722.6 transmission. And a lot of our customers like to service their own transmissions. We recommend that you do so every 40,000 miles, which is a basic fluid service. But it's not uncommon for us to get a phone call that after a customer has serviced their vehicle no longer moves. Here's why. So you've got this red dipstick tube cover. And a lot of people mistakenly fill the engine with transmission fluid. The fill for the transmission is actually located further back here in the firewall, and there's a black colored cap covering that guy. So just wanted to point that out to you guys. If you're servicing your transmissions, stay away from this. Your engine will be overfilled and your transmission will have no fluid. As it pertains to transmissions, the next big ticket item is the conductor plate that I have here. So on the 5-speed transmission, it's not uncommon for the transmission to go into limp mode, have issues shifting, and you getting error codes related to speed sensors. The speed sensors that the module is referring to are embedded in this conductor plate. The 5-speed transmission is a fully electronic transmission. It's fully electronically controlled. And all of the solenoids and sensors, and you've got a fluid level float and your electrical connector are housed on this plate. When the sensors fail, you get an error and it requires you to replace this guy. Replacement is fairly simple. You're gonna drop the pan, you're gonna drop the filter and the valve body and swap it out. It's not uncommon for customers to swap it out and not clear the error codes in the transmission. So that's why it's very important to have one of these autels or a similar tool that will allow you to talk to the transmission control module and erase the fault codes. Once the fault codes are erased, the transmission is going to shift just like normal. So if you're having shifting issues and you're having those speed sensor codes I mentioned, start here first. The next transmission I want to talk about is the 7-speed that was introduced in 2004 on the 211 models. So if you had a rear wheel drive 211 model after 2004, or 2004 forward, sorry, you're going to have this 7-speed transmission. It has a similar issue to the 5-speed. Unfortunately, with the 7-speed, the transmission control module is also integrated into the conductor plate. And what that means is replacement is a little bit more involved, because if you replace it yourself, you still have to get the control module married to the vehicle. It's actually VIN coded to the vehicle. Mercedes considers them a theft relevant part, which means the VIN number and variant coding lives on a module on the conductor plate. In the aftermarket, depending on what version of conductor plate you have, you can send out your plate and they can make repairs or replace the failed speed sensors so that you can reinstall the conductor plate in your vehicle. If you go the OE route and install a genuine Mercedes conductor plate, you are gonna have to go to a dealer or an independent to have the plate married back to the vehicle. If you don't, the transmission will be stuck in limp mode or worse. You simply won't be able to drive the car. These conductor plates, same or similar codes to the 5-speed, you're gonna have codes related to speed sensing. And when that happens, you'll replace this guy. Just like on the 5-speed, you have all of the solenoids. They're located right on the conductor plate body. All right, so when it comes to servicing these transmissions, you definitely want to be replacing the fluid every 40,000 miles. That's going to be the minimum service requirement. If you're doing it every 40,000 miles, you're probably going to get a lot of life out of your transmission. Additionally, if you want to take it one step further, I would recommend removing the conductor plate and valve body from the vehicle, removing the solenoids from the conductor plate, and cleaning the screens as well. One thing to keep in mind if you're gonna go the route of removing the valve body is you have a very tight seal here at the O-ring for the electrical connector. Be very careful when you're popping that out of the transmission, because the last thing you wanna do is break the neck of the conductor plate. You're going to need a replacement conductor plate after you do that. Well, that about sums it up for W211 transmissions. Hope you found this information super helpful, and I hope you feel more confident servicing, troubleshooting, or diagnosing your W211 transmissions. If you have any questions at all, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Additionally, we've got a bunch of other videos for the W211 that we'll link in the description below. If you like what you've seen today, be sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Okay, I can give you a stronger clap.
Please.
Make my booty clap. All right.